I am Gianmauro Cucurum, member of the European Galaxy team and an administrator of US Galaxy EU. And today we talk about our experience managing US Galaxy EU. So the European Galaxy Survey, it's a public Galaxy survey where everyone can create an account or can make a login using the Elixir AAI infrastructure. We provide free compute and storage resources. By default, you have 250 gigabyte quota, but you can request more if you need it. There are more than 2,500 different well documented maintained bioinformatic tools together with a lot of reference genome available for your analysis. Some numbers about the survey. At the moment we have 33,000 registered users, more than 162,000 workflow has been executed on our infrastructure. In total, there are 23 million of jobs executed. Just to give an idea of the load, last April, we executed about 2.8 million jobs. And we collected more or less 2 petabytes of user data. That's an overview of the architecture of US Galaxy EU. We have at the front line our HTTP proxy by NGINX. Then we have the Galaxy server connected to an Isilon cluster that provides a peta file system together with other several smaller file server. We have a computing cluster managed by HT Condor with CPUs and GPUs hosted to the Denby cloud. Our computing cluster is completely virtual. And we have a database using PostgreSQL, a CFMFS infrastructure with a Stratum 0 and Stratum 1 server. Stratum 0 is the server that is offering to the whole CFMFS network the Singularity images. We have a Jenkins cluster for our continuous integration activities. And the message queue by RabbitMQ, the message queue server, it is a bridge between Galaxy in Freiburg and all the remote Pulsar sites of the Pulsar network, created into the data centers of our partners across Europe. Here are some specifications of the boxes that we are using at the moment for our services. We are using CentOS 8 as an operating system. Galaxy server is a box with 40 cores, 256 gigabytes of RAM, and an SSD hard drive. The database server is more or less the same, except for the fact that it has 2 terabytes of RAID 1 SSD drive, and Jenkins more or less similar to the other one. US Galaxy EU is also part of the US Galaxy.star network, that is a collaboration between public Galaxy instances across the globe to have a common set of tools, workflow, and reference data. There are three main instances, so US Galaxy EU is one of them, then we have a US Galaxy.org in US and Galaxy Australia in Australia. But the community is growing and there are other US Galaxy servers available in France, in Belgium, in Estonia, in Spain, in Italy. Okay, today I would like to talk about the open infrastructure. That is the way that we are using to manage our infrastructure. We have several Git repositories hosted on GitHub platform and the Jenkins cluster that takes care of all the continued deployments activities needed by our infrastructure to be always updated and configured as requested by us. And the next slide I will show you how we are using this together with several tools like Packer, Cloudini, Terraform, Ansible, and OpenStack. Okay, here we have the first repository infrastructure where we have all the Terraform scripts about the elements of our infrastructure. Terraform is a tool for building, changing, and versioning the infrastructures. And as you may see here, the Terraform syntax is quite simple. Here we are. We have a commit that is heading a DNS record into our DNS server in the Amazon platform. And as soon as I committed this, as I pushed this commit into the repository, Jenkins realized that and started Terraform in dry mode. posting to the GitHub page the result of this test. And so we can see that Terraform would like to add exactly the DNS record that we want without changing anything, and more important, without destroying anything. So merging this pull request, Jenkins restart again Terraform, but this time in live mode, and the DNS record has been added to the DNS server. Here instead we have the same approach, but using Ansible with our infrastructure playbook repository, where we have all the Ansible playbook managing our use Galaxy U infrastructure. Here we have a list of the commit that we pushed into our repository to update use Galaxy U from the previous Galaxy version, the code of Galaxy from the previous version to the current one, the 2105. It's happened about 10 days ago. And as you can see, I commit describing that I pushed all the details of the new release into the test instance, that I updated the Ansible playbook to fix some issue with the new release. And the day after I realized to have a stable version of my Ansible playbook, I made the same for the main server. And again, every time that we push a commit in our this repository, Jenkins, not every time, but Jenkins during the night, restart the Ansible playbook for use Galaxy U. So use Galaxy U has been redeployed every night. And that's all. I mean, this commit is describing that we changed the branch used for the Galaxy code to be deployed into the main Galaxy server. And as simple as that. Working just with the GitHub interface and making some adjustment on our playbook, we updated the Galaxy server. Okay, that's for the services, but we are doing the same for the computer infrastructure. We build a machine image named the Virtual Galaxy Compute Nodes, VGCN, containing a pre-configured operating system and installed software to run all the Galaxy jobs as needed. And here we have a repository where all the codes are hosted. Every time that I made an update on this repository, Jenkins realized that and start a project using Packer, Cloudinut, and Ansible, producing a new machine image. And then this new image is uploaded into our cloud infrastructure, ready to be used to create a new virtual machine. And after this, we have the image to create a virtual machine. Then we have another repository that physically created the virtual machine using a Python code that parse a YAML file where we describe the version of the image that we want to use, where describe the detail of the workers that need to be created as a virtual machine in our cloud, the number, how much of them, which flavor, which software need to be installed in the virtual machine, if we need to add a volume, or if we need to enable cgroups there. As simple as that. And every hour, Jenkins parse this YAML file, verifying that the virtual machine running for each class of workers are exactly as expected, like in the case of the worker C64. But instead here, you can see for these two are missing, and immediately Jenkins ask OpenStack to create two new workers as requested by our configuration. Another element of the use Galaxy infrastructure is the job dispatcher naming sorting at, and here we have the GitHub repository. It's a Python code that takes care of create a runtime the proper destination for each jobs, for each job. It's leveraging the Galaxy Future, naming the dynamic destination mapping. And there are two main YAML file in SortingGet describing the destination that we can use for each job and the detail of how the tool need to be executed on our class. For example, the data fetch tool need have to request to the computing cluster one core, a node with a slot with one core, this amount of memory, no GPUs, this runner, and can set this environment variables and so on and so forth. Another element of the Galaxy infrastructure is TIAS, a training infrastructure service. Is a service where you can request a completely dedicated computer resource for your training through a web form, and it's been used more than 200 times since 2010. And you can use all the material of the Galaxy training network in our infrastructure. I would like to spend a few more seconds on this phrase. Completely dedicated computer resources for your training means that we have a web server that can be used by your students to be enrolled into a role of the Galaxy server dedicated to your training. Then the TS administrator can ask our automated infrastructure to create some virtual machine for this, for your training, that should be started at this day and destroyed at this, at the end of the training, using this flower, and that be that it's an amount of virtual machine that need to create it. And then we have a special function in the SortingGet code that realize that your user has training roles, and then prepare a dynamic destination with all the requirements needed by our job scheduler to execute the job of the train, the jobs of the training into the training nodes first. If they are full, then they are moved to the regular queue. We mentioned in automatic way also the tool that are available in the Use Galaxy U. We have a repository where there is a YAML file describing all the tools need that are that need to be installed in Use Galaxy U. And we are using Ephemeris, that it's a Python library for managing Galaxy tools, index data, and workflows. So here we can see Cristobal that created a pull request to add a new tool. And it's as simple as that, just few rows describing the name, the owner on the toolshed website, and this, in which section the tools need to be created. And then on Saturday night, Jenkins processed this YAML file and install all the files needed on the Use Galaxy U. The job scheduler that we are using is HT Condor. You can find here this web page all the details about HT Condor, but I would like to highlight a bit what is special useful for us. In particular, the fact that new workers are automatically added to the pool in a few seconds. So until as soon as your virtual machine is ready up and running, immediately Condor realizes that and add to the list of the resources that can be used by your job. HT Condor also has a really nice nodes failure detection routine that realizes that one of the nodes is not working anymore, and then remove that node and submit the jobs to another machine. You can easily add the GPU's resources. You can also easily enable cgroup's limits there, and we have some limits for cores and memory. If your job is using too much memory respect to what has been declared by the submission job, then your job will be removed from the running queue, put on hold, and another task take care to increment the amount of memory used by your job and resubmit it to the computing cluster. We are also ranking nodes by total load matrix. That means that your jobs are always delivered to the less busy nodes. And we have for free another feature that the jobs that the nodes that the crazy nodes that the nodes that are going crazy for any reason will be skipped by default. At least they are at the bottom of the list. So your job has less probability to be submitted to those nodes. HD Condor provide also an expressive framework for matchmaking resources requests with resource offers. So it's a Condor jobs realize which is the right resources to be used for your jobs, not of the users to know which is the proper queue that should be used to submit a job. HD Condor is also a friendly and active worldwide community that organizes every year a week-long workshop. I participate in some of them. They are really, really useful. In the end, what I show you today is an effort of the European Galaxy team intended in the extended way, not only all the members of my colleagues that are here in Freiburg with me working at Use Galaxy infrastructure, but also other colleagues distributed across Europe. We are all working together hard to supporting users in different way. We are fostering communities with our community outreach and result dissemination program, or providing subdomains with their own welcome page and toolbox. We are working on producing scientific tools and workflow. There are a lot of teaching and training activities in place. Look at the amazing works of the GTN network. I talked about the infrastructure development, but there are also a lot of other activities like an Apollo server managed completely by their own, by Elena and Anthony, Marco that is working on Ansible rules and the Pulsar network, or Anne and Ivan that are contributing tools for the climate and the ecology domains, and a lot of other activities. In the end, my take-home message are: listen to your users. They are using your infrastructure. They can help you a lot. Give to them an easy way to contribute in an easy way, indeed, because they can do it if they are if they found a way to do it. Automate steps making better experience for people who use it. As I show it to you, every user can contribute to our infrastructure in easy way using our GitHub repository. But it's also super easy for the system administrator to use this kind of infrastructure. It's a win-win situation. Both of them are happy to use this kind of infrastructure. And most of parts of our open infrastructure are used by other colleagues across Europe to build their own infrastructure. It works, it's easy, can be useful also to you. Have a look. This is the URL. And that's all from my side. Thanks for listening and enjoy the rest of the conference.